Hey everybody, thanks for joining me today. I wanted to share with you a cute little page that I did. I originally did it for a hip kit casting call type thing, but I actually did not submit because I got a new job literally that week. So I want to share with you guys a fun fall themed page. I actually have really been missing making videos. I've been recording some, but I seem to never get that downtime to actually do the voiceovers, so I apologize if my channel has been super boring lately. But what you actually are gonna try to do, because I do work extremely early in the morning, so by the time I get home, I'm like exhausted. And my hubby was out of town for like 40 days, so I'm finally trying to get back to normal with my everyday life, and so I'm hoping you guys can see more videos from me soon. But anyway, I went to this really cute little town called Snohomish. It's one of, by far, my favorite places to go in Washington. It's a cute little antique town, and they always do a really good job of theming their different shops for the season that you're in and making everything look super cute. But we actually decided to go one Sunday, and it was almost closing. I mean, it literally was going to close in like an hour. But we still managed to have fun and take a ton of pictures, so I love it. I use, on my project lives, I try not to stick to one specific brand. I actually have a really fun time just building all kinds of random things I already own instead of trying to go out and buy stuff. Of course, I am like a normal girl. I want to buy stuff anytime I get a chance, but this is what you're going to see a lot in my project lives, is I'm just grabbing stuff from different kits, different things, and just putting them together. What you're seeing on this one is actually like a Heidi swap embellishment with some washi that I picked up. I believe it was from, one was from Daiso, one was from the, I think it was, I want to say Hobby Lobby or Michaels. Can't remember, but I love these little teeny embellishments, you guys. These are a great way to kind of add interest to your page. Little embellishments that I found, I just throw all my hearts together, and then I throw all like leg pieces together. I don't care if they're gems or wood or what, but I find that easier to kind of do layering and piecing. So, but that cute little bow you saw, that was actually from Daiso. I got it for like $1, and they had a really awesome, awesome setup there, but those tags, those are from Michaels, and they're actually really cute. They're just plain matte tags. They were cheap. I got them on a clearance. I got them on like a discount. So I actually like using them on my pages. And then here I am using a stamp from a stamp set that I've owned forever, and I've only used once just for that heart. It was like the first time I used it. So if you're like me, try to get those out and use them. We spent all the money on them. We might as well use them, so. But this is the cutest little bicycle I saw out in front of one of the little shops. And I just thought it was so adorable, and it had to go on my page. So now, I like to sew on everything, but I don't know what it is lately. On this page here, my sewing machine was working fine, but my little handheld sewer, I've been having issues with it lately. So I tried it on another page just yesterday, and it didn't work. So I'll figure it out. But those clear embellishments for like hello, I want to say that was Heidi Swap. But those are really fun. I really like those. Oh, it might have been crepe paper. I don't know, honestly. They all get mixed together. But this is a really cute little picture. My niece is obsessed with Julian. She is in love with like being an older cousin, I guess. And she's into baby dolls right now. So I think she almost thinks that Julian's a baby doll. So yeah, that's why she is constantly like glued to him wherever we go. I'm going to slow my recording down a little bit because it's making me dizzy watching it. But if I go really slow, I just want to let you guys know it's going to like, it could take forever to watch one video. And I don't want you sitting here like all day watching a video. So there we go. But you'll see here, I just use all kinds of different things. I use simple stories cards. I use stuff that were cut apart, even old pieces of paper that I just chopped down to smaller sizes. And you're going to find that that's actually going to get you the most for your actual supplies. I love Project Life cards, but I'll be honest with you, the rounded edges annoy the living daylights out of me. I still buy them, but I don't ever end up using them as a base on my page because I find it's annoying when it's like, I don't know what it is. I think they slip out of the page protectors too easily, but when the sharp edges, I notice that doesn't happen as easily. So Yeah, that's why you're going to see me doing a lot of my pages with the sharp edges. And a lot of times you can just trim down whatever paper you have to make a 4x6 or a 3x4. So I personally, I enjoy that. That is actually a sticker that came in one of those thicker sheet packs. Those are the best, by the way. If you guys are just getting started and you don't really have a lot of thickers, buy the ones that already say words on it so you don't have to buy a bunch of different thickers. But here I actually used, look at that, that's a sticky note from Heidi's Swap. I had a huge set of them, never end up using them, so I've been trying to incorporate them in my project life. But then I just used some ephemera from a different pack. I don't even know the pack, to be honest. But this is cool. I actually used my Rana Designs app to put the words on there. And I didn't realize it until after I made my page that two of my cards say Happy Place, but that's a fun way to kind of get a locator on your actual picture so you know like where you actually took it. You just use your app and put it on there, and then when you print it, it looks really pretty on your page. Oh, this coffee spot is so bomb. If you guys ever want to go get coffee in Snohomish, go here. It's like right by the Mexican spot. And the guy makes really good coffee. It's actually like I like it better than Starbucks personally, but there's a lot of places better than Starbucks. I'm not a huge coffee snob, but man, that was some good stuff. This was actually kind of, I guess you could say it was kind of like for my birthday in a way. We wanted to go there and just kind of have a fun time together. And my cousin Shayla was there, my sister, the baby, and then Adriana, my niece. So it is the coolest little place to go for just getting away and having some fun. And it's so close if you live up in the area. But they're always cute. Like, those shops there are always full of fun stuff. So if you guys are in Washington and want to go there. Make it like a Sunday of it and just go and have some fun. But I like to layer up a bunch of random stuff, like I was saying. But I don't know about you guys. Have you guys actually scrapped with the crepe paper confetti yet? Because that is the cutest paper line ever. And I really wish that I would have bought more. But whatever, I know. I try to buy so much and not a lot of it gets used. So I'm trying to freeze myself on it and just use what I have. So if you see such a huge random selection of what I'm using, it's because I'm trying to use what I have. So, and don't get me wrong, this past few months have been very fortunate to be able to do a lot of scrap shopping. And that's why I'm putting myself on a freeze because it's getting to be a little expensive. Oh, and I just subscribed to the Hip Kit. So I don't know about you guys, but I've been wanting to do the Hip Kit for so long. I was part of their group on Facebook and everything, and I just couldn't afford it. But now that I'm working, it's pretty awesome. I'm like super stoked. And then I got the one that has like Christmassy themed stuff, so I'm so excited about that. So right here, what I'm doing is I just took a makeup sponge and I put a little bit of my distress paint right on the sponge. And I do that because it's more of a dry method. And if you try to use just straight from the dauber, what you're going to see is it just bleeds underneath and you don't get that sharp edge. So, oh, and it dries super quick. So you're not sitting there waiting around for it to dry. Do it if you guys can. Of course, I probably ended up covering it up. I do that a lot. Oh, man. But oh, I didn't cover it. Yay. Okay. So I just used my little my typewriter. And I like getting some use out of it because it does make it look more clean and just a pretty little setup, so. Oh God, I just love how this page turned out. I haven't looked at this in a long time. Like I said, I did this originally for the Hip Kit design team call, and I actually didn't submit it because I found out I got my job right as I actually finished up this page and everything. So I was so excited and overwhelmed, and my brain was going a million different directions. So I didn't actually submit it. I felt like I wouldn't have been of value to their team if I got on because I'm starting a new job and I didn't want to like feel like I'm not on top of my projects and stuff. So now that I'm working there and I'm getting used to it, maybe the next time it comes around, I will apply, hopefully. But these are so cool. These are all from, what the heck was that? I want to say the Open Book Collection. All these little ephemeras. Oh, and I had to capture this. My little niece and my sister, they have a really awesome relationship, and it's really refreshing to see, you know, a little girl look up to her mom so much. And for me, I think it's just the cutest thing. So I wanted to take a picture of it. Let's see. And I don't know about you guys, but I've been struggling using my gems and stuff lately. I used to use them on absolutely everything. But lately, I don't know what it is. I haven't been using it. I have a hard time. But I love that little sewing machine because it really does add an extra accent to things. I think it's really fun when you get to see like just little details like stitching here and there or little extra pieces here and there. Especially on my project life, I actually treat my project life like they're mini scrapbooks, like scrapbook pages. Because when I look at it as a whole, then I think about too much about like trying to like match everything. But when I look at it as like individual little pages, I don't really care if it matches. It looks cute and I really love it. But this little picture was taken when Julian was 11 months. He just turned one last month, so he is just a big boy now. I'm curious, are you guys interested in seeing a flip through of some of my Project Life pages? I've actually been making them, I just haven't been recording it because I didn't have the time to do the process and everything. I don't know if any of you guys are aware, but it does take a long time to do a recording, editing, voiceover, publishing, uploading, all that crap. It takes forever, and I feel so bad when I see people like saying mean things to other YouTubers because, oh, the editing on this is bad, or oh, the lighting is terrible. You gotta understand that these people are all doing it as a hobby. They're not doing it as a career. And if they are, they may be in the early stages of it. All those YouTube people that you see out there that are like movie style YouTube, like it looks like you're watching straight up TV, they have production companies doing it for them. They may do sit down and do the like in front of the camera thing, but if there's other people that actually do the editing and do all that work for them. So don't criticize anybody if their videos may not be the perfect video, because it can really discourage scrappers, but also it can really hurt some feelings. So try to think about that. I mean, I'm a little bit calloused because I've worked in the telecommunications for many years and people have said some evil things to me. So I don't personally get too upset, but there's a lot of people out there that may not hear that kind of stuff. So hopefully you guys enjoyed it. I know I was talking about a whole bunch of everything else, but here are some close-ups of my paper or my pages of the cards. And I hope you guys liked it. If you guys want to see some more, just tune in. I'm going to try to put out some more videos here in the next week or so. But I hope you guys had a happy Halloween and enjoy your fall. Don't forget to just start scrapping. It's the best way to get your supplies used. So have a good one. Thank you so much. Oh, hit me up on Instagram @CarterSands. Have a good one. Bye.